It's now very common for us to be sat out in the water, particularly on natural venues like this one. And I've been getting asked lots and lots of questions over the last few weeks about how I actually set my kit up when I'm sat out in the water. Quite often we're speed fishing, and quite often, you know, you need to be spending as much time actually fishing. So being comfortable, having all your tackle around you is obviously paramount. However, the nature of the beast is that lots of these venues, you are having to bring quite a bit of kit with you, and it can be a long walk to your peg as well, so you don't really want to bring everything. A couple of people saw my barrow when I was at Tamar a few weeks ago, and they were just saying, you know, how is your barrow so compact? And it's basically because I don't carry too much tattle, but I've got enough kit to keep me nice and comfortable. So in this video, I'm just going to be giving you a bit of a walk around tour of the setup, but more importantly, not what I'm using, but why I'm using it. Now, because I fish predominantly feeder-only events, I don't often find that I need to carry a platform. Basically, lots of the venues that we go to now have got a 50 centimeter wading rule anyway, and with a seatbox like this one, even with all six legs down, it's super, super sturdy, even when the legs are extended fully. So straight away, that's somewhere where I can actually cut back on these feeder fishing events where I don't have to carry a platform. As you can expect, when you're fishing with multiple rods, some sort of a roost is essential, and that was basically the simple setup of my roost. It's positioned here so that it's high enough off the water to keep my reels off the water so they're not getting wet, but it's also low enough to allow me to quickly and easily access everything in my drawer. Really, really nice and simple. Okay, the next thing is the keep net bar. The keep net bar is something that I leave on all the time. Basically, if I needed to put a second net in or even a third net, I don't have to think about it. Just grab the net and these are already in position. It's just speeding everything up and making it much more efficient. Keep net, as you can see, that white bag there is what I use to, and what I've used at Tamar to stake my keep net out, which is something I'll show you in a moment. Feeder rest. Nice compact feeder arm, but the feeder rest as well is very important when you're speed fishing. You can put your rod in multiple positions along that, and there's nothing there to get your line or your braid snagged on, so it just keeps you nice and efficient. Now, the side tray setup is something that I played around with a lot recently, and this is the one that I'm currently using at the moment, and this is the one I use at Tamar. The first one is a self-supporting side tray, so that doesn't need any support underneath it, but this other one here, the one at the back, is it's one of the ones that needs a support arm, which I'll show you in a moment. Now, the reason why I've got it set up like this is purely because obviously it gives me loads of surface area there. These are really nice and easy to put on the barrow, they're nice and compact. But because this is the self-supporting side tray, what this actually does is, because of that bracket there, it allows your landing net to go there. So that means I can position my landing net right where I can get it, right, really nice and quickly and easily. There are lots of people out there that try and have the net over here, or they have it on here and the wind's blowing it about, and by having it there, it can't go anywhere. Okay, now the key to this as well is that I have got a bracket there. Okay, so that bracket stops the landing net handle going all the way down there. All right, so that keeps it in that nice angle that you can see. And because I've got that there, I don't need anything behind me like a roller or anything like that to rest the butt of the landing net handle on. So that, again, it's something that you can cut down on what you're carrying, and it just keeps everything really nice, smooth and compact. And the final thing, as you can see, my feet are in the water. When I was at Tamar last time, it was almost a heat wave. Just a little tip to keeping yourself cool is just position your foot plate just under the water. It's amazing how it can keep you cool on these red hot summer days. One thing that we really need to think about during the summer months is fish welfare. And when we were down at Tamar, quite often it was flat calm, bright sunny days like this. And, you know, obviously you've got to think about having especially large quantities of fish in your keep net. And one of the things that we had to do was basically stake the keep net out. Now, sometimes you can just use a bank stick. Quite often that's all people do, but on some venues it might be a little bit too deep out there to get a stake in. So I just use a worm bag.
So for staking my net out, all I basically do is get a rock, so you need some sort of a weight, worm bag and some string. First thing I do is, if you just pinch the bag about there, then get some scissors, be careful not to litter. So that's actually put a hole actually in the bag itself. So all we do then is get the string, and I just do one big loop, nice and simple. one big loop like that. Okay, you can trim it off if you want, keep it nice and neat. Okay, so you just got one big loop, that's all that is. All you do, get the bottom ring of your keep net, thread that through there again. So that's attached there, and then all you do then is exactly the same again, thread that through there, and then thread the whole of the bag through the loop again. So that's attached, so that's attached to your net and your bag, and then you get your rock, and that is what you use to weight your net out. Nice and simple.
Being more efficient in your fishing is obviously going to help put more fish in your net, and ultimately it's going to allow you to enjoy your fishing more. So I hope you've enjoyed this little bit of an insight into how I set up, but more importantly, why.